day in July. The sun shines down from a bright blue sky. It makes water temperature rise, and it's no surprise when that liquid begins to vaporize.
Evaporation, condensation, precipitation. It's the water cycle.
Evaporation from the warmth of the sun turns a liquid into gas, an invisible one. The vapor going up condenses, must come down. Precipitation begins to fall to the ground. Higher and higher that vapor floats to the sky, collecting together in the atmosphere high. Molecules cling as the air gets cold. Clouds begin to form as condensation they hold.
Evaporation, condensation, precipitation, it's the water cycle.
Evaporation from the warmth of the sun turns a liquid into gas, an invisible one. The vapor going up condenses, must come down. Precipitation begins to fall to the ground. Now those fluffy white clouds above that lake in July get heavier and darker as the day goes by. When you look to the sky and it begins to rain, the water cycle is the one you can't blame.
Evaporation, condensation, precipitation, it's the water cycle.
Evaporation from the warmth of the sun turns a liquid into gas, an invisible one. The vapor going up condenses, must come down. Precipitation begins to fall to the ground. It rains on the mountains and the water flows down, 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 deep in the ground. Then it feeds the streams and the rivers and the oceans, and then it starts all over again. Evaporation from the warmth of the sun.